And nowadays, this new form of wave is reinstated under the fact, if you don't adopt that, if you don't believe a universal religion, meaning that everything is okay, then you are intolerant. My dear respect brothers and sisters, in the era that we live in right now, there are many trials that the Muslims and the Muslim community is going through. And like I mentioned last time I was here, there are many isms that are spreading among the ummah. The ism of capitalism, the ism of imperialism, the ism of feminism, and the ism of atheism, and etc. And unfortunately, many Muslims are swallowing these pills. They're swallowing whatever come toward them, no matter what sources, how authentic these things tend to be. Now, we are faced with a new wave of a new ideology. And my dear respect, brothers and sisters, this member is meant for us to be immune from all these isms and these new ideologies that is coming up against our way of thinking. My dear respect, brothers and sisters, in the past, there used to be a new wave of philosophers that called for a universal religion. A religion where everyone is accepted. A religion in which that there is no religion that is what? Wrong. All religions are okay, or all religions are fine. And nowadays, this new form of wave is reinstated under the fact, if you don't adopt that, if you don't believe a universal religion, meaning that everything is okay, then you are intolerant. Nowadays, we're seeing governments, and we're even seeing Muslim governments who are trying to push for these things. My dear respect for our sisters, and not only that, they're paying the top influencers in the media and social media for us to accept this. This is being funded heavily by an even Muslim governments who have now adopted what they call the Abrahamic house. In which that, yes, you could have a church and a synagogue and a mosque in the same token, and all of them are okay. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has stated clearly in the Quran, and he said, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِ غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ. Whoever follow a religion other than Islam is not going to be accepted from him. As Muslims, we believe that Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent as a final messenger to all humanity. He was sent to correct the deviation that people have done and invented by their own religion in the past. This is very clear. And Sayyidina Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, what he was sent for? He was sent to correct what the Israelites were doing in his time. This is the basis of religion 101. And the thing is, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us. He said that, I swear by the one, my soul in his hand. No one hears of me from my own nation, a Jewish or a Christian. And then he dies and he does not believe in what I was sent with. He was a person of the hellfire. This is clear. There is no negotiation here. You know, each religion has its own prophets, and all prophets have their own religion. No. As Muslims, we believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent 124,000 prophets to this earth. There's a hadith about this. And all of them are different religions? No. All of them are the same religion. The religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the religion of submission toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Islam. And we have to be proud of this, because otherwise it's going to be a chaos. As Muslims, we believe that Sayyidina Ibrahim was the father of all religions. Many people have differed on him. What's the religion of Sayyidina Ibrahim? But what? The Quran came to reaffirm. The Quran came to clear this doubt. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مَا كَانَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ يَهُودِيًا وَلَا نَصْرَانِيًّا وَلَكِنْ كَانَ حَنِيفًا مُسْلِمًا وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. Ibrahim was not Jew nor a Christian. But he was what? And he was a Muslim. And he was not among the polytheists. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues. وَقَالُوا كُونُوا هُودًا أَوْ نَصَارًا تَهْتَدُوا قُلْ بَلْ مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا. And they say, be a Christian or be a Jew and you shall be guided. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said what? Sayyidina Ibrahim, he followed what? The true path toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the religion of Islam.